Hey, hello people, welcome in my video. Today I want to talk what I do after the Windows installation. How do I set up my Windows? Beforehand, of course, we quickly do a activation code into it. We format the C drive. We make backups beforehand from the files you want to keep, of course. I prefer to go to a local account instead of a login account from Microsoft, because you don't get backup files on your OneDrive from Microsoft. I don't like that. I have my own backups for all kinds of things, but if you like it, you can take a Microsoft account, of course. But I take a local account personally, and then I go to privacy settings in the installation. I set everything to basic level or fully disable it at lowest as they can track me as possible. I like that. And then we're going to the window after the installation where this video is all about. And that's we're gonna dive in right now. So people, after the Windows installation, you come at the desktop of this time Windows 11. You see mostly nothing on your desktop or some pre stuff like browser from Microsoft, mostly some pre-installed stuff. So what I do is mostly disable a couple of things, but we first go to the start button. We're going to settings. Then we go to personalization. We're going to taskbar behaviors, and here you see, for example, search. That's this search one. You can either disable it, you don't see it anymore, and if you want to keep it, I prefer that because search is a very powerful tool in Windows. I prefer it on. For example, there's also task view. I don't like it, or I'm not used to it yet. I need to learn it, so I disabled it, but I always know where I can find it, so I disable it. Witches. If you like to see the weather or anything from witches, like a date or anything, you can either put it on or off. I prefer it off, so I put it off, and otherwise you get it somewhere in the left corner, probably I see now. But I disable that. Chat from Microsoft or anything, I personally don't use it, so I put it off. And like pen tool, touch keyboard, virtual touchpad, all kinds of things, I set it off. I don't know what standard is, but I set it off. Then I go to taskbar behaviors on the lower one, and then I do multiple things. Like when using multiple displays, show my taskbar apps on, and I set it on all taskbars. So on all my monitors, I have now the same taskbar with the same icons I have on my main monitor. But you can also do it on other preferable options if you like that. Show my taskbar on all displays. I like that, so I think that on. So I keep that, and you can read them yourself. If you, for example, want to automatically hide your taskbar after using, you can put it on. For example, this Windows 11, of course, and I like it because when I used it from the start, I kept it on the center Windows start button. I keep it on center, but you can do it on left. Like 25 years, it's already on the left. So if you want to go back to the older state of Windows 10 and below, you can put it on left. You get just your start button on the left. Believe me, I was also a long time user of Windows. I use it on the center for like a month, and now I'm fully used to it. At the beginning, sometimes, of course, I did go to the left. Oh no, my button isn't there. I need to go to the middle again with my mouse. But you can get used to it, and I prefer it now. And then when after doing that, you have like icons. You can depin something, right? So to depin, you see, for example, Microsoft Edge browser. You can right click it. For example, this Chrome. You can unpin it, and then it removes from the taskbar. And if you want to pin it, I will tell you later. So this was the first part. So after I depin multiple stuff, I also want to pin couple my taskbar, what I use frequently in my Windows. For now, I have, for example, task manager, control panel, the very old control panel. We can click on it and you see this control panel. It normally comes like this. It's very difficult, but I like to have large icons and you see all very powerful functionalities. I want to pin it on the taskbar. By doing that, for example, you can do it first. I want to show you how to unpin. Just right click, left click on unpin, then it's removed. You don't see anything. But I have a second tip very quickly. I have, of course, pre-installed stuff on my desktop to get or hide it. For example, for a streamer functionality, you want to hide it, for example, for this video now. But now I want to show you guys it, and you get all my icons on my main monitor. To get the control panel, you type search, you type in control, and then you get automatically panel. You right click that and you can pin it to the taskbar or to start, but I want to show you how to pin it on the taskbar. And see, now we have it on the taskbar. I use it frequently, so I put it more to the left and I put it like this one. You can also do task manager. So you search task, you see the task manager, you can unpin it or pin it, preferable what you want. I like to use them frequently to check out my PC resources and stuff. So I want to pin it, but I already have pinned it. But you can search it in the search field, task manager, if you have an English version of Windows, and then pin it or unpin it. For example, you can normally get that task manager by control alt delete on your keyboard. You get it. You get the window screen and you click manager on. But now we can just, with a single left click, you can get this information, performance, and all kind of hard drives as settings and so on. I also pin my Google Chrome. I use personally Google Chrome, but you can also use Microsoft Edge or Firefox or Mozilla. I don't even know which all kind of browsers are available on the market. So I install the Google Chrome, I right click it, show more options, and then I pin it to the taskbar. Now it's unpinned because it's already pinned. But you can unpin it or pin it by right clicking, show more options, and then pin it, okay? So that's what I use frequently. So I put that preferable after the task manager and the control panel, then I do my Google Chrome. That are my three basic I always keep, I really like. So yeah, those are basically pinning stuff in your taskbar. You can do it like that. If you want to pin multiple folders to your taskbar, you can just open the folder, then it's like in your taskbar, and then right click, show more options, and pin it to your taskbar. From folders you use frequently, it's a handful feature. I personally put them just on my desktop for instant clicks, tuck tuck, and I'm there. So mostly after depinning and pinning what I prefer, I mostly go to Windows search and then I type in msconfig. Why? There you can see your startup items from your computer, like a program, like anything you have installed. You can disable or enable it. And then we're gonna try it. You can press on your keyboard Windows button on the left and S, you get the search field, or you can click of course on the search button on your monitor with left click and you type in msconfig and then you enter it with your enter key on your keyboard. There are multiple tabs, of course. You can see it quickly on the screen with me, like some services. You can also disable it there, but mostly I do it somewhere else. But we did talk about the startup items. Open the task manager and then you're at the startup items. I currently have like a Vanguard from the game Valorant. I Vanguard from the Valorant. If I not use it much, I can right click and disable. Now, if I do that, it got disabled here. The status is disabled, and to enable it again, put it on enabled. You can do that with multiple things, with Steam or like Logitech drivers, or there are like other stuff from Microsoft. For example, this Microsoft Teams, I don't like it to start it up automatically, and I disabled it. See, if I disable this Steam, for example, you see my last BIOS boot up was 11.8 seconds. For example, disable this one, it should change. After the next boot up, you can see if it's changed to different seconds. But I want to keep it on, so I keep it enabled. So that's what I do after the pin and depinning. I type in msconfig and disable and enable stuff what I don't want or to keep. After doing all these three first steps I told you, I go to changing my graphics card to see if my frequencies of my monitors are all set up right. I have, like, for example, my main monitor is a 1080p monitor and gaming monitor is 144 hertz. I want to be sure it's set up at 144 hertz. Otherwise, you have a lower performance of your monitor. Normally it should do it automatically, but I always check it personally. So I right click on the desktop, right click, then display settings, you get a screen. I have like three monitors and 4K on the right. My middle one is my main monitor. It's a 1080p gaming monitor. So we're going to the bottom of that one and we're going to advanced display. and we check if the Hertz is the right one. Now, I have 144 Hertz. With NVIDIA graphics driver, you have like around 133.85, as I see now. There you can also change, for example, to display one. It's a 60 Hertz monitor, the 4K, but with HDR. And the other one is just a variable display. To see if it's not like on 59, you check that as well. You want 60 if it's 60. If you want 120, you want 120. Of course, preferable options. And then I click on my biggest 4K HDR monitor. And the next thing I do is check if HDR is set on. I keep it on set on. And then after that, I check my HDR settings. So mostly it's clicking on this one, on the HDR. And then I check to the brightness. You can do auto HDR. I don't do that. I set it to like 85. It's exactly 85. Play streaming HDR videos. I put off. I do that all manually. I like manually stuff. Now then my HDR is also set up right. My Hertz frequencies are set up right from all monitors. And then we're going to the next. The next thing what I do is power options. The power plan from your PC or laptop, anything you use. You can either go to the shortcut we created at the first three steps. You can click on it and you get the control panel, or you can click on the search field, type in control panel and then enter it or click on it. Tuck, we click on it. You can mostly see it like this. You click on the category, it's easier. Then to large icons or small, depending on what you want. And then power options. Of course, you can also do in the search field power options, all up to your own preference, what you do. But then we are on power options. And for example, I have a desktop PC. I want to have it on high performance. Mostly the many things, your voltage on your computer stays a little bit more stable on high performance. But if you have a laptop, for example, you keep it on balance or power saving to save more battery of your laptop. I want, for example, the high performance. So I click on it and you get highlighted with this blue circle marker, and then you can change the plan. I do only mostly a couple things. If you click the plan change, you click it. I do like turn off the monitor after 20 minutes. That's mostly what I do. Put the computer into sleep. I do never. And then change the advanced power settings and you get this menu. And what I do is normally it's like this. I click on the hard disk because I have a desktop PC. I do personally hard drives, set it on never, turn off never. Why? I don't want to wait for my hard drives. I have a quite decently fast PC. I want, if I click anything on the C, D or E or F drives or how many you have, I want instant reaction, right? I have an SSD not to get in sleep mode. No, I need to work fast as possible. And if I go editing a video, I need to go fast as possible. I don't want to wait any seconds for anything. So I put it on never and then apply it. You can also do multiple other things, but mostly if you have the high performance plan, it keeps everything on high performance. So then apply it and press OK. Then you have done your power plan. You can also do other power plans, the power save. You can all minimize it. Mostly it's already. So the next big thing as a gamer, personally, I put off the enhanced pointer precision of your gaming mouse or mouse in Windows to get no acceleration. So when you're moving, it not accelerates, so you overshoot your target or anything. How to do that? You go to the control panel or just type in your search field mouse, mouse settings, click. And you get your mouse settings. You go to additional mouse settings. That's basically the way you get normally in control panel your setup. And then you click on the pointer option. ID check. This one is automatically on and chance point precision. That's basically acceleration of your mouse. If you have like 300 mouse DPI on your gaming mouse because you like that and you want some acceleration, you put that marker on. Personally, I use very high mouse DPI because I play MOBAs and RTS games. I don't want to overshoot. And I put it off, apply, and press OK. The next big thing is the sound from my PC. So that's very important to have everything like mostly the same as your previous Windows version. So by doing that, you go to search, or you can go to control panel, by the way. You type in sounds, go to settings, Here you can do some basic stuff like volume. I mostly set at 75%. I do that over many years, sometimes around 75 to 80. So it's not fully open, the volume. So you can control other stuff and it's more balanced. Then you go to more mouse settings. You click it and you get some panels. Normally it's like this. You see multiple sources of audio. Some are enabled, some are disabled. I keep only the ones I keep, want to use. So for example, I disable this one, I disable this one. Disable all except the ones I want to use on the speaker setting, the playback setting. Then everything is off except the one you want to use. You can click on it. You can even change values. But I have 75. You can do it on multiple ways. You can also do it in the bottom right corner. You're sounding at 75. But you can do it here and multiple other locations. But I do it on 75. I disable all sources I don't use. For example, my Blue Yeti microphone also have a speaker. I don't want to use that speaker. I have my headset or my real speakers. So I don't need Blue Yeti speaker. I disable it. Some digital output I don't use personally. I disable. I keep all everything disabled. And then later on, I do this. Show the disabled devices off. And then you only see the ones you use currently. You go to the second tab, and for example, here you see I have a Yeti microphone, and here you also have multiple microphones. I disable the ones I don't need, and I keep the ones I want to use. Of course, you can do way more in-depth settings, and I do that, and then disable the device off. So the next what I do is making some shortcuts on my desktop. For example, here you can see recycle bin, this PC, C drives and other drives. For example, open any folder, one of these, but they are private. So this also a folder. You see this PC, left click it, drag it to your desktop and release your left mouse button and you have a shortcut. You can also do it with the C drive, D drive or any drive you want. Even you can make this a shortcut. You can search anything in your search fields, drag it to your stuff. You can also search it here, open the folder, what you prefer, drag it to your desktop, and you have instantly access to all these kind of folders. I personally have three folders I use frequently for my editing and my backup videos for my channel. I have instantly access by these three folders. Of course, I can type them manually in the search, but I find it a little bit a longer route to get that quicker access. So I just have some quick access on my desktop, some shortcuts. Some people, of course, prefer clean, minimalistic workflow on their desktop. It's all your preference, up to you, but I like to have some fast, instant access to some folders or drives. That's what I like to have, and that's why I have them on my desktop. All this, what I did previous, all these steps beforehand, I can do that very quickly. Of course, I explain it a little bit in detail, but you can do it very quickly. After all this, I do at first always the GPU driver. Either you have NVIDIA, AMD GPU, or maybe in the future any Intel drivers. You can install them now, and after it I will do the Windows update. Why not after the Windows update? Otherwise you get a GPU driver that's an older version. You need to maybe remove it with a software tool to get clean on your PC. But now you do first the GPU, and then I do personally the Windows update. So you go to each of these manufacturers, AMD, NVIDIA, Intel, whatever you use. You download it on their main websites and to get the latest drivers. And then after that, I do the Windows updating. All kinds of things, anything from Windows update. And I mostly not install any other software from my motherboard or anything. I all use Microsoft default stuff. If any problem occurs, I download a solo driver for each problem and I fix it. Mostly default drivers are very well solid constructed. They are very good. Mostly I have no problems. I mostly only do the GPU, maybe in sound driver or something from Realtek or anything what you have on your motherboard, I will also download. So after the driver of the GPU, I do, of course, Windows update. I fully update every version of Windows, all things, your Windows Defender upgrades, anything what you like, I install with the update. And then is that all settled. I forgot to mention, after the GPU driver installation, I do a restore point. If anything happens, there's anything wrong with your installation, all kind of things, you create a restore point. And then you can always go back to that restore point. So how to get that? You type create restore point. It's already the second, but you can also type only restore point, I believe. Restore point, and then you get it at the top. You click it. You can do multiple things here in this system protection. I do mostly install it on the C drive. You can configure it, create, and your older system restore, you can also select there if you have any problem is occurred. So you click it. You see restore system files and settings. Next. Now I have currently 3. You click one and then you go to next, and Windows will go back to that previous state. And that's very handful for installation and stuff. You can always go back. For example, in Windows updating, there can also happen a lot of problems. For example, errors or anything. You can always go back. So after the GPU, I mostly do a create restore point. A system restore point. I create one and then that's settled. And mostly after the Windows update, I make a second one. Then if that's all right, then I can always go back. That now, just a quick tip, make a couple of restore points. That's very useful, guys. And of course you need to install all your programs. Hooray, it's not that difficult task. At installing, for example, your Steam, your Discord, or anything you're using, your edit programs or your streaming software, you can all download and install it at the same time. Maybe you need a specific game on Steam, you download it at the same time while installing other stuff. And maybe when the first time you enter the software, you can then do the settings to your preference and save it. And then it's done the job. All these kinds of things, what I did in this video, I can do with installing Windows, the key, the privacy, the pinning and depinning, and the GPU updating, Windows updates, can be around 50 minutes. And installing a game, if you have fast internet and maybe a fast SSD as main drive, you can do that all in 45 to 50 minutes. And then you're ready in a game. It's not that hard. Of course, the more you do it, the faster you are into doing this kind of jobs. But I did it so many times in my life. I know all the settings. I do mostly multiple settings at the same time. And when I need to reboot, I reboot. I reboot for multiple functionalities at the same time. So I have to reboot for every part. For example, after GPU, they're asking, you want to reboot? I say no, because I do a couple of things and then I do a reboot and I do basically save one reboot in time saving, right? So yeah, guys, it was basically the video, a very long video, I know. I wanted to explain it a little bit in detail, and yeah, that's what I prefer. I can all do this stuff in 45 to 50 minutes, and then I'm, for example, in an RTS game already, or in my Dota, or Valorant takes a little bit longer, but yeah, you can do this very quick. So if you have any questions, anything, or positive criticism, say it all in the comment section below. And yeah, I will check it out, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked it. Consider a like, subscribe. It is all free. And otherwise, I see you guys in the future. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.